fact, I do have a little surprise for you, and here it is. Yesterday, I received a phone call from Bruce, and we chatted for a little bit about, everything that's going on in the world right now and what Bruce has been up to, and we even heard from Miss Patti Scalfa, which was a really great treat. So it was a pleasure to talk with both of them for a little bit and see what's going on with them. So sit tight and listen to this phone conversation between myself, Bruce Springsteen, and Patti Scalfa. I hope you enjoy it.
Hey, Bruce, it's Jim. Nice to hear your voice.
Hey, Jim, good to hear you.
So these are strange days indeed, huh?
We're
doing now.
Yeah, I'm just calling to check in on you guys and all our friends and fans out there, and hoping everybody's well and staying safe.
Yeah, everybody, we're all following orders and doing the best that we can and washing our hands and practicing social distancing. I saw you up on the internet with the New Jersey Pandemic Relief Fund video.
Yeah. It's a nice thing that Tammy Murphy, the governor's wife, is coordinating, and it's going to help the state. A lot of people can give it a hand, you know. I mean, there's so many problems with everybody being overwhelmed and facilities being overwhelmed already, and we're just really, we don't know where we are in the whole thing. Is it how much longer it's going to go, how much worse it's going to get? So there's something there that people can get involved with if they'd like to, you know. It's going to be a helpful and good thing.
Yeah, it's a great idea, and it's njprf.org for people that can donate. You know, nobody could have thought of something like this ever happening, and you know, and this virus is affecting everybody. I know friends of yours, you know, Tom Hanks and Rita Wilson, and just recently Jackson Brown has been tested positive for that. So this thing's everywhere.
Yeah, I'm very worried. You know, I've known Tom a long time, since Streets of Philadelphia, and Jackson I've known forever. He was one of the kindest people to us when we very first got started. He actually put us on the bill with him and let us open up. And he's a great, great, great friend of mine. Not only is he also one of my great heroes as a songwriter. And so I've spoken to him a little bit, and he seems to be doing all right at the moment, and just wishing him well and a lot of love.
Well, that's great to hear. Yeah, we're all sending our prayers for everyone that's stricken with this unfortunate virus. Have you spoke to any of the members of the E Street Band through all this?
I talked to Steve quite a bit, which is always a source of great entertainment, so he keeps my spirits up.
Yeah, he definitely is. So, we're all just trying to figure out ways to keep busy throughout this whole thing. You know, there's only so much exercising I think you can do. How many times can you run around the block or whatever you need to do?
You know, everybody's just trying to stay busy. You know, Patti and I are hanging out a lot together, which is great. We're having a good time together, and we're on a farm, so we have our horses here, and we get to spend a little time with them, and that's been nice. And I've been busy a little bit just working on some music, and so I've tried to keep my day as full as possible and to keep myself from going completely cabin fever crazy.
So let me ask you a couple of quick questions. So as far as playlists are concerned, you know, I'm sure your fans are kind of interested in hearing what songs you listen to. Do you have anything you can let us know about?
Well, I have all kinds of old music that I listen to, you know, old blues, and I have playlists of like the fathers of rock, Ralph Muddy Waters and Chuck Berry and Bo Diddley. And then this morning I was listening to Del Shannon, who is sort of undersung as a hero of rock and roll, and he's had one of my great voices. And I have playlists with him and Dion, so two of the great, great singers in rock music. So I've listened to them quite a bit. Oh gosh, Future Islands. Mm-hmm. I like the you know, I'm all over the place.
Yeah, bouncing around. You know?
Yeah.
That's great. I know you're an avid reader too. Have you been any particular books?
Oh gosh, let me see. Let me get my book list here and
okay.
See what I can find. Hey, Patti, say hi to E Street Radio.
Hey, hello, everybody.
Hi, Patti. It's Jim Rotolo. How are you doing?
Hi, how you doing, Jim?
Good. How are you? How's everything going with you?
Good.
Yeah.
Things are going very slowly, but it's good. Actually, I have my list of 50 favorite albums of all time, the Rolling Stone official ballot.
Oh, wow.
That's what I'm doing right now.
Well, that could take days to put together,
no
really.
No kidding. It's reminding me of things that I want to listen to. Again.
Yeah, that's true.
What are you doing, Bruce?
he's looking for his reading list, his list of books that
he really? I just heard a big song come out of this. His computer is sitting over my head right now. I'm on the couch and he's standing over me. He found it. Hold on. Nice
okay.
talking with you.
Nice talking
Take
with you,
care.
Patti.
Take
All
care.
Right. Hey. All
okay.
Right. My buddy Richard Ford have been rereading Lay of the Land and Independence Day, beautiful books, particularly if you live on the shore, because that's where they're all set.
Mm-hmm.
And I would suggest that trilogy. It's Independence Day, or let me find it, Lay of the Land, and The Sports Writer. Great trilogy of books set on the Jersey Shore. Fabulous to read, highly entertaining. Read a book on the Wrecking Crew, you know, the musicians who've played behind all the great records in the 60s in the LA studio scene. So that's really informational and a lot of fun. And then I've been reading some books about the movies. Warren Oates, I'm a big Warren Oates fan,
mm-hmm.
you know, who is in some of my Bring Me the Head of Alfredo Garcia and Cockfighter and Tulane Blacktop, fabulous character actor. So I was reading his autobiography. Also, I think it was in The Wild Bunch also. Just a great character actor. And then I've been back reading some of the John Cheever short stories just because they're beautiful and there's just something lovely about them that soothes your soul a little bit. And some Jim Thompson. I'm always rereading some Jim Thompson. If people want to get really psychologically crazy, those are fabulous books to read.
So in all this reading and playlist making, I know it seems like you're keeping pretty busy. I also, you know, I understand that you're also working on some new music now.
Yep. You know, got that going. So that's going well, and hopefully it keeps going well. I have no predictions on it yet, though.
No, I mean, as far as, you know, a release date or anything, I mean, everything's, you know, postponed until further notice, obviously. Through all this time, I know you're working, you know, obviously you're in the middle of working on new music, but has any of this downtime inspired you just to write any more music, or is just you already sort of writing stuff?
At the moment, I feel too overwhelmed by that hasn't been in the cards for me.
Well, so Bruce, next time we talk, let's have you maybe put together a music playlist for the channel. I mean, you've got so much great songs there that I'm sure your fans would love to hear about.
I got plenty of them, and I would love to play DJ again.
That would be awesome. That would be great.
Also, I want to send out our thoughts and prayers to, of course, all our fans and friends in New York that's really going through such a tough time right now. Fans in Italy and Spain that we love so much. Well, stay safe. You know, that's all I can say. And everyone everywhere, we're thinking about you and praying for you. So God bless. I hope it's over soon.
All right, Bruce. Thanks so much for taking the time today.
Take care.
Love you too, guys. I know a lot of you guys overseas can't get this, so. Creed. Share it around, okay? To the Italian friends and Bruce's message to you guys. We love you all.